2018! Oh my God. Was that not one of the biggest and best years of my life? Woo! I did a lot in 2018. Yeah. 2018 was crazy. I should say that. Okay, so my favorite moments of 2018. I mean, you can't probably even count them, but let's just start with the top 10. So one of my favorite things that kicked the new year off was I won a settlement with MTV. Also, speaking of that, I had my last season of Teen Mom on MTV this year in April. And speaking of MTV, I really, really, really enjoyed the MTV Movie Awards. Love the MTV Video Music Awards. And I loved being brought back to MTV for what? The show that's on TV right now, MTV's X on the Beach Celebrity. So watch that every Thursday night. There's a lot of just five amazing things that happened with MTV, and I left and I did it right. Imagine that, doing your life right. So it was epic, epic. Okay, there are so much more other things. That was the first five. Woo! The next five, I had a lot of personal growth. So traveling was huge, and I had so many amazing, magical moments from being in Nice, France, going to the Cannes Film Festival, and all the designers dressing me. I could like literally walk in any parlor and I'd have the best fashion gowns given to me. I was with all your favorite fashion stars, all your favorite models, you name it. It was Nice, France will forever be in my heart. I had such an amazing time. So thank you, Nice, and thank you, France. I love you both. Dubai, we went to Dubai, Sophie and I. For one, we had an amazing New Year's leading into 2018. Hong Kong, shout out, love you. But then there was Dubai, which was, I think they could have a second home there. It was that, like, romantic, luxurious. They believe in marriage there. They do a lot of things that I wish my American heritage, my culture, how I was brought up, I wish there would be more of that still, of how I was raised, but I found that somewhat in Dubai and I loved it. The ocean was amazing. People were amazing. I can't wait to go back to Dubai. It was gorgeous. Oh my God. We went to Costa Rica. And Costa Rica was amazing with the humpback whales. So gorgeous. Epic. It was my 27th birthday. I had the best birthday party ever. No fake friends. No new friends. And it was gorgeous in Napa. And why not have the best wine tour this year? It was epic. 10, you know, there were so many more other amazing things from traveling to whatever. But I think 10, if not being at number one in my heart, I know, can I categorize all these amazing moments in 2018? Would be seeing my daughter get to spend the night for number 10, seeing my daughter, which was recently like this week, get to spend the night with her grandfather on her dad's side, and her spending the night at her dad's house on his 10th anniversary of him passing away from his car accident was just the epitome of how lucky am I to witness this, how lucky am I, how blessed am I that, you know, his dad's alive, we have this opportunity, from grandparents to aunts, cousins also being there. It was just everything that we needed. And over the last 10 years, as you've seen me deal with depression, suicidal thoughts, counseling, craziness and drama from the loss of Sophia's father, it was such a beautiful moment and it really just made my whole life. And that was probably one of the best days of my life, the best moments of my life, not just of 2018. So I am so blessed that we got through this, and as a family, we've gotten so strong, and it's just really beautiful, and we're ready to start our next decade in a new, powerful, happy way of dealing with loss and loving and missing Derek Underwood. So, always a special piece of my heart. I can't say it enough. There is so much happiness and greatness that happened in 2018. I would say decades. There's been decades. This year was a epitome of decades on TV, a decade of loss. And I think just starting a new decade is what 2019 is and what the end of 2018 is to me. So, on that note, 2018 to me in total was just so wonderful and showed me everything that I needed to move on to the next chapter of my life in such a positive way. I cut a lot of people out this year, and I'm so grateful and happy I did. So, claps for everyone who cut all the bad people out of their lives, because it really just made such a more amazing year, month after month after month. My saddest parts of 2018 that I had, I would say, well, I had, you know, sad moments of loss. I had sad moments where our family dog, Blue, that everyone knew, had passed away, and that was literally the most devastating thing I've had to witness in a while. Our dogs are everything. They travel with us. They love us. They're there through the ups and the downs of, you know, losing a family member, breakups, family crisis. You name it, Blue is there for so many of our family and friends, whether they're going through cancer or hard times. Blue just had that spirit, the joy of being with everyone, and they'd be attracted to him. So Blue was an amazing animal, amazing best friend, and he will always be missed. He was the best dog ever. We miss you, Blue, so much. Other sad moments. I guess nothing really was as sad as losing Blue, but there was just some really crazy, tragic moments in my life, like, skirt, hold up, what is going on and what are these people who I'm around? Number one, the Beverly Hills jail situation was probably the top tragic, like, what the heck am I doing? Why am I being in the situation of someone holding my property, people trying to sue me, when I'm the freaking one being attacked, and all my property being held, and in the nicest place in Beverly Hills. So now I think the Beverly Hills Hotel is just a scam and a con artist. So don't go to the Beverly Hills Hotel, because I will never. So that was a really tragic moment. You know, another strength building experience, even though it was sad because it was so negative, was I worked my ass off, like for 4 months, training so hard and boxing. All that boxing workouts for the anti-bullying celebrity match, which really just went down the drain because the promoters all wanted to go against me for some reason because they were jealous. It's kind of like reality TV went into the celebrity boxing world for a second, and the jealousy just spewed into an anti-bullying, what could have been an amazing anti-bullying charity event. So I didn't show up because that was the right thing to do, and that was just really sad. And it was sad that they actually didn't really get any money for the charity. And it was sad that they invited bullies, like the other Teen Moms who have bullied me on Teen Mom, and other celebrities, or they're not really celebrities, I would say none of them are, because I wasn't there, and oh, the fight went nowhere. So that was just a really sad, there was real sadness and tragedy, there was just tragic situations that bound me, and then there was just pathetic situations. So that was a big part of 2018 and the patheticness of the people. Another like high point, I would say, as a business person, as an entrepreneur of 2018, there was so much that I learned and I got out of 2018. It was my 2-year anniversaries for all my companies. Froco, the frozen yogurt store, Furnished by Fair, my furniture store, Sophia Laurent, the store, the business that I shared with my daughter, Sophia. And it was so cool that we made the Inc. 5000 list for the top companies of 2019. That was very cool to me, and seeing what success you can actually accomplish letting your dreams pass. Like, I want to open up these companies. I want to be successful. You do that. You make amazing business lists. You meet amazing business colleagues. And that was one of those high moments for me this year as well. And learning that also in business, that when your dreams pass and you're ready to move on to the next phases of those businesses, what's taking brick and mortar to online, because if your online was making more sales than your brick and mortar, or just moving from food, fast casual, to just going into the grocery store. So I really learned where to put and where to place my business efforts so that my family and I can have more freedom and make more money in an easier way. And I think being in the public eye, having so many of my employees attack me, try to sabotage my companies, and really just do me in and sue me and many other things in 2018, I really knew that it was time to make a change for the better and for my family and for I. And I'm so much happier, so it was great. So, I would say my 2019 resolution, because I've made so many changes in 2018, my 2019 resolution, because of everyone who I met along the way and all of my journeys and all of my trips around this globe, would be, I wanted to say first, thank you to all my amazing fans who really love and support myself and my daughter. Thank you to all of my amazing compliments that I got this whole year for doing the right thing in my career and for my goals and for my values. It meant the world to me more than anything this year. So my goal for 2019 is to, because social media was such a big deal to all of our family and friends and supporters, is to make more amazing videos on my YouTube channel. Post more on social media, which was Instagram, Snapchat. A lot of you had said, oh my God, I'm watching your Snapchat, I'm watching your Instagram, I wanna see more on your YouTube channel. Like, where's all your trips? Where's that? Like, what have you been up to? So I guess I was a kind of a little bit like greedy with my private time this 2018. And I loved that I got to do that. I really needed that. And I'm so excited to meet my goal, whether that is get, I don't know, 2 million subscribers on, what is it, YouTube channel, or like, you know, I'm almost at 2 million on Instagram, so thank you guys. So maybe we'll go to like 10 million on Instagram, 10 million on everything. And I just want to have some big goals. And I just challenged all my business entrepreneurs out there. Like, I'm so excited to have more entrepreneurship around me with my masterclass team. So that's another thing I'm looking forward to, is another level and another step in 2019 with my masterclass with you guys, to connect with you and guide your dreams, your goals, your successes, and merge them with some of my inspiration. And I can't wait to meet all these goals and all these videos and all these ideas. So happy 2019, guys. It's gonna be amazing. And thank you so much for all the love, the support, and just making me be the best person, the best bear that I can be. I love you guys. Almost forgot my favorite beauty moments of 2018. Okay, let's not forget the live that shook. Actually, there's a lot of things shaking in 2018. My booty shook the internet with booty injections on Face the Truth. Vivica Fox, you cannot even handle it. But girls, look up my girl in Las Vegas, Flawless Las Vegas, for the best booty. Now, the other thing that took live over on my Instagram was Designer Vagina. Yes, and it's looking fabulous. You know, in fact, the best designer vagina out there. Shout out to Dr. Sheila Nazarian. I made her a top 9 of 2018, so hashtag that. I love Mrs. Sheila Nazarian in Beverly Hills. Ooh. And I also loved my best injections, from jawline to cheeks to the amazing, most amazing, would be Mrs. Heather Aesthetics of Las Vegas. I will put her in the info below. She has done an amazing job locally. Couldn't ask for better. And these brows, darling, beauty would not be without brows. So Vina's Brows in Las Vegas, I will also put her in the comments below. And that is the best beauty of 2018.